In the lobby of Ramsey Solutions, I love these, a church debt-free scream. Pastor Larry is with us, and Phil, welcome, guys. Glad to have you guys.
It's great to be here.
Glad to be here.
Honored to have you. You guys are from where? What city?
Jasper, Indiana.
Jasper, Indiana. And the church that has become debt-free is called, named what?
Shiloh United Methodist Church.
Very cool. Very cool. Where's Jasper exactly? I can't get that in my head.
It's about an hour south of Bloomington, Indiana.
Oh, okay. Okay. Very cool. Good. Very neat. I love it. So tell me the story, Phil, or Pastor Larry, one of you. Tell me what happened here and the whole process.
I'll start the story and Phil can fill in the blanks. In 2002, the church started its third building project and built a family life center. At the end of 2002, the records show that it was $2.3 million in debt. Mm-hmm. At that point. I came into the picture in July 1st, 2013. At that point, they had reduced it down to $732,000.
Okay.
1998, I heard you for the first time on the radio in Owensboro, Kentucky. And my wife and I have been debt-free ever since.
Mm-hmm.
When I was told I was being appointed to a church that had $732,000 in debt, it scared me to death. And so as I got into the setting and into the situation, we began to talk about, you know, what we could do to get out of it. I suggested that we do and plan a Miracle Sunday. And a Miracle Sunday is a Sunday that is picked in the future as a date to have the debts paid off by.
Mm-hmm.
And so in the spring of 2014, we contacted the bishop of the Indiana United Methodist Church, Bishop Coyner,
mm-hmm.
and he had December 6th, 2015 available. So we scheduled that, and we were going to make it a big celebration and a wonderful day. Lots of partying, had a meal scheduled and all that kind of thing. And so then the goal was to have it paid off. And on, we sent the letter out September 15th, 2014.
Mm-hmm.
At that point, we owed $575,000, or just short of that. And then 365 days later, on September 15th, 2015, we cut the check for the final payment.
3 months early.
Yes, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it was.
Wow.
We missed our goal.
I hate it when that happens.
And we also overshot. And
yeah.
So now we have money in our capital improvement.
That's so awful to have savings. Yeah.
It's tough.
It's awful to be able to do ministry in the market and not have to borrow money to do it. That's just, he says sarcastic. So basically, the whole journey of $732,000 is about 3 years long.
Yes.
Okay. And Phil, what was your part in this whole thing?
What I've been doing is I've been teaching the FPU class probably since 2010.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So we've
had probably
100 people go through FPU.
Mm-hmm.
And not only from within the church, we've had people from outside the church. So it's been a great ministry to the community.
Absolutely.
Right.
Very cool.
And then we've also said we just finished the second time, the generation change for our youth. And we had about 11 or 12 kids finish that up,
neat,
including my daughter, which I'm really proud of her for that.
I love it. So how many folks in your old congregation?
About 300 worshipers on Sunday morning.
Wow. So you've had almost everybody go through FPU then, is what
getting
it sounds
close,
like.
Yeah.
I mean, 100 family units would be a bunch. Yeah,
yeah.
That's pretty cool. So when you two really join hands, I mean, FPU coordinator that's on fire for the whole thing, and pastor who's been through FPU at another place and hates debt, this is a perfect union right here to get rid of some debt.
And there were a lot of people in the church. They caught the vision. And we're excited and wanted to see the debt disappear. So it wasn't just me. It wasn't just Phil. It wasn't even our committee. A committee was put together 2 years before I arrived. It was called Mission Possible, but it was in the midst of a pastoral change. And so not a lot happened, and they didn't get a lot of traction until after we started talking about the Miracle Sunday and moving forward.
That's fun. Well, you set a vision. That's what you did.
It was a lot of fun.
Very well done. Well, and somewhere there is a Mr. Wesley that's happy right now.
I'm hoping.
Yeah, because he, as you know, he hated debt. And he'd done a lot of writing about money. Make all you can, give all you can, save all you can. One of my favorite Wesley quotes on money, anyway. And so, and very, very interesting. Well, congratulations, you guys. And now the church is poised to just do ministry. All the tithes and offerings that are coming in, all you can do is just help people now.
There's $66,000 in the budget now that wasn't there before. It was $5,500 a month paid out in interest and principal every month on that debt.
That now can go to help people instead of keeping some bank open.
And ministry.
That's just awesome. That's just the way it should be. That's exactly the way it should be. Well, congratulations, you two, and congratulations to Shiloh United Methodist Church. That's a lot of fun. So I'll have to catch you at the break, Pastor. You two got to see this. My grandmother's grandfather, however many great-greats they were, was a circuit-riding United Methodist / Brethren before the split back in the Civil War days. Fought in the Civil War from Indiana and ended up riding south and carried a Bible on the back of an old mule and was a circuit-riding Methodist United Brethren preacher. And I've got the Bible from the 1800s. I'll have to show it to you at the break. So
that'd be great.
So it's near and dear to my heart that Shiloh United Methodist Church, Jasper, Indiana, baby, $732,000 paid off in 3 years. And we got video and audio of the whole congregation doing their debt-free scream. Fire it up, guys.
Three, two, one.
As it should be. I love it. I love it. I love it. Congratulations, you guys. Very well done. And Phil, thank you for leading the class all these years and being diligent to do that. A lot of families set free with that. Thank you, sir. God bless. Very neat. Very neat. That's how it's done right there. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, click the subscribe button to get the latest content and check out these other great clips from the show. And so you have to break the cycle. You have to flip this thing on its head and make it behave. You've got to get so fired up and wired up that your broke friends think you've lost your mind.